Okay, Russ, rather than showing you a video or just a video that I made about my health and my nutrients, this is what goes in my smoothies that I make. So we've got radish, we've got cabbage, super, super amazing. There's our radishes. This here is, I think, what is this? Kohlrabi. Yep, that's kohlrabi. And this is kale. Another flat of kale. This is arugula. Really healthy. And look all these up. Do your own research, man. I'm giving you what's going on. Again, another tray of kohlrabi. Another one. I really cook a lot, grow a lot of that. This is a really cool mix. This is amaranth and red Russian kale. Look up the health benefits and nutrients of each of these. And then you've got the microgreen peas. Super, super, super loaded with nutrients. And they taste absolutely amazing. It's just crazy. This is cabbage. The healing benefits of cabbage, it is just incredible what this plant does at this stage. And then for like the main course of a salad, I could just make this as my main ingredient. It's black oil sunflower seed, super, super just dense, real rigid. But it just tastes absolutely amazing. I mean, you can see it's a tough plant. And then you've got these little wimp radishes over here. I moved them around today and bumped them and hurt their feelings. But again, nonetheless, radish is just an amazing, amazing plant. You know, and then from there, dude, you just add spinach, kale. There's a lot of great salad mixes out there that you can get. And then as far as fruits, I always like banana. If I have kale, I definitely am going to have banana in there because kale just has a really tough, tough, you know, taste. It's some people love it. To me, it's kind of annoying. But other than that, man, then you just, I mix it in a Viatamix or one of those ninja things work probably out well. You need to emulsify the stuff. And then add ice, and then you can add water, and then from there you just blend it to the consistency that you think you like. Some people don't like thick stuff. I personally don't mind drinking it fairly thick, almost like a gravy, and add a little bit of water. That way I can have a container, a mason jar. I can get two servings out of that. But that's it, man. That's what I do, and then I just refrigerate it. And I can make a whole day or two in advance and then just go through. And if you don't mind the taste of apple cider vinegar, you can put a tablespoon or two in the smoothie if you're gonna, you know, store it for a day or two. Plus that apple cider vinegar, the healing benefits of that are just incredible. Absolutely incredible. But so I hope this answers your question. Take care, have an amazing day, and have yourself a blessed holiday. Bye-bye.